Caution, let's go.
Paul Menard. You called for the caution.
Hey, yo.
And Kevin Harvick, who did not pitch, will benefit from this one.
What about Chase Elliott?
He is running in second place right now after all the pit stops. How about that?
You did never know.
He gains 9 positions during the pit cycle by staying out. Some days you have a little bad luck, a lug nut ends up in the wrong place. Some days you have a little good luck.
Yeah, that's definitely some good luck. He's also going to go behind a lot of those cars that already came down the road. They're not going to come back in. They're going to stay out. So
remember,
he's back in it.
But he's in.
Remember, Paul Menard had a lot of damage from that crash back at lap 2. They worked and worked on it. Here's what happened.
Say thanks, Menard.
Now that's what happens when the tire goes down on the straightaway. You got a little more time to soften that hit.
And remember that big free pass battle that had been going on? Bubba Wallace. It's the free pass. So it's win-win for both of them.
Well, Chase Elliott. Yeah.
Chase Elliott also. Wow.
That was big for a lot of people.
Oh, you know what this means, Mike?
What's that?
We're sitting up for an exciting finish to this race.
Well, I'm sure, but Larry, with 98 laps to go and knowing what we know,
hey, man, I'll start.
Do you see this
white line? They seem to lose some grip. So,
Kane, Bane. That rhymes. Yeah.
I don't believe either one of them hit anything.
But it's still wrecked. Well, they kind of hit the grass, but okay.
And that's that razor's edge I was talking about. Just not a lot of grip when you're side by side.
Well, Larry, as much as said, we were going to have one more caution.
That's a big break for the 4-car guys. That's what he needed. Now he's got himself
in position Chase
to get back in this race. Big time.
Whatever.
I mean, they were battling hard for that free pass spot. They were racing.
Well, they were the caution, so neither of them get it.
See what happens here. Bane's right down on the door of the 95.
It's pretty early.
It's good.
I mean, he did a great job. I think he would have saved it, but then made contact with the 6 car
and
brought both of them around.
Now, we'll wait for the ruling from NASCAR, because with those two being the only cars on the lead lap, one lap down, whether either of them would receive a free pass. No, usually the car that brings out the caution is not eligible.
Yeah, which one?
Yeah, which one do you think it ought to be?
I'm not making that call.
I mean, Kane was the one that spun, so would you give it to Bane?
You know, guys, normally with this fresh of a surface, no more laps than we've run, I would tend to believe they may stay out. But I think with the issues that we've seen and that a lot of these drivers, they have anywhere from 10, 12, up to
anyway,
15.
Anyway, yeah, that happens. Kane Bane.
I think pit road's still closed right now, so this is a good time to think about it.
Now, I would be surprised, wouldn't you, Larry, that if the 4 ends up coming, because I think he's liking this set of tires. He's fast. That's one of the only ways he's going to make up the track position.
I agree.
Yeah, he, remember, on his tires, they were just a little fresher, but they didn't have that additional heat cycle like the other drivers' tires did.
So if the caution flag is charged to the 95 and the 6, there will be no free pass.
Yep. Well, anyway, I'm going to start.
Harvick on
you. You're not going to beat him.
Oh, Newman! Ouch. Well, there's the caution.
Jamie?
No.
2 seconds, and I'm not kidding, 2 seconds, Ryan Newman had just come on the radio and said, I need 4 tires, and I need them now, and he's straight in the wall.
Well, as you said, you run that outright as far as you can, hoping for a caution, and hoping
Yikes.
It's not you.
Yeah, hoping it's not you. Well, too bad.
That's the inside of that right front look to me like. And what you feel a chunk of the tire or the cords or something snap. That's why he knew it. He felt some sort of vibration. Something's changed instantly in the feel of that steering wheel.
Why no one?
That's a heavy impact.
It's funny. You, it's going. Everything's good. The feel's fine. And then all of a sudden, bang, it's gone.
horrible news for Newman, and it's equally bad news for Stenhouse and Wallace, because this is going to bring them right back to the other cars that will now be on the lead lap. Kyle Busch, Harvick, and McMurray, one lap down. 200 miles an hour into the wall.
Both those are even that first hit was hard. That second one was still pretty hard legs.
Ouch. 8-7 Orioles.
Open for the four lead lap cars. McMurray will get the free pass. And everybody else who is stuck one lap down is going to have to decide to pit and be one lap down or take the wave around on the tires when they got back at lap 291.
Yeah, we know Stenhouse and Bubba Wallace is going to pit. Looks like to me that Kyle Busch, the 18, and Kevin Harvick in the 4, they're going to stay out. Chase Elliott's pit. Those other drivers, Mike, they have to take the wave around. They don't have a choice.
Well, we got 30 laps to go, so we don't have all that far to go.
Anyway.
Chase Elliott's not
going. Yeah, that happens. Thanks, Newman.
Or is he now? I'm going to double check it. Yeah, I don't know.
Well, he thinks he is, or he wouldn't be in the pits.
But see, I look at this as that's exactly what these guys wanted, because you know they wanted to, the leaders that are up there now that had come in earlier, about 10, 15 laps,
one last lap pass. But you know what, Mike, if you're Kyle Busch, you're going to feel really good about yourself if you can hold Kevin Harvick up to win this race. This again has been the best part of the year so far.
You see, Kyle Busch, he slowed down in the middle of the corner just a little bit more than 1-2 that time. And we didn't see the 4 gain as much. We saw the 4 gain just a tiny bit right here. Wow. Turns 3 and 4.
3.
Two cars.
Three.
And gets out of the way and gives them clear track.
Yeah. He's going to move up the racetrack.
Pretty much. Didn't hurt anything.
What happened to Chase?
Harvick a little. Yeah. Down to 11? Just a tiny bit.
Yeah, he's been there.
Go all the way.
Huh? He's been there for a while.
Just for the record, that 72 car is not.
You know what would be nice?
What?
A caution.
If Harvick won.
No. A caution.
A caution. Oh. I'd rather see Harvick than McMurray. I mean, than Busch.
Why?
Because I don't like the Busch boys.
Says this race isn't quite long enough. You could hear it in Kyle Busch's voice in the pre-race. This was going to be his day. He's in his sponsor's backyard. He's in a track where he runs well, and he wants to be the man to give Joe Gibbs their first win of the season.
Well, he's getting mighty, mighty close.
The white flag wave.
One lap to go. Sounds like one round back.
Well, we've been talking about wanting to see somebody go head to head with Kevin Harvick.
It's over.
We got it right here with Kyle Busch.
Stanton struck out for the fifth time.
Four straight finishes, a second or third, everything but a W.
Kyle Busch, gonna win it.
Texas for Joe Gibbs and Toyota.
Yeehaw.
Kevin Harvick, 3 tenths of a second back. Samantha, his wife, she's pretty happy.
Season and you haven't gotten that win, you've been so close, it weighs on you.
Norm Miller, he's the president of Interstate Battery. What a great guy. He's been with this team forever. Ever since Bobby Labonte drove this car and won in it here. And he's such a great guy.
Anyway, let's celebrate, I guess.
44th career win. For Kyle Busch, last win was Martinsville in October. And Kyle Busch taking home the checkered flag as today's Sunoco fueling victory. Third Texas win and his 20th start here. And he becomes the fifth different driver to win in 2018. That have their signature move after winning a race. And Kyle's is to salute the crowd.
Well,
to 8 times now. Wow. 3 times this year. And here's Kyle gonna take a bow and salute the crowd.
Cheers? Yeah, a few of them. Yeah,
they gotta appreciate a guy like that, you know, that he worked hard for that win.
He definitely earned it.
One of 8 drivers to win for Joe Gibbs Racing. They score their 7th victory at Texas among 4 drivers. Here's Jamie with the runner-up.
What a performance by Kevin Harvick today. Roller coaster of emotions. You guys were so dominant. Then the issues on the pit road. How do you put all that aside, Kevin, and drive the way that you did to come back and finish second?
Well, we're just fortunate that our Busch-Light Ford was as fast as it was to cover up what was just an absolutely pathetic 2 days on pit road. So, you know, we just had a really fast car. Kyle's car was just fast enough to where I needed to go the whole run to be able to make up the ground that I needed to. We did as well in traffic there. We just got to thank everybody at Stewart Haas Racing and everybody on my team for putting together just a great car.
Led 87 laps today, brings it home second.
Boy, and what a rivalry in the making between Kyle Busch and Kevin Harvick. 8-1-2 finishes between them, 3 this year.
Oh, tremendous.
We've not seen the last of this.
You throw 78, the 78 of Martin Truex Jr., and we're going to have a 3-way ride.
That's right. The common denominator is Kyle Busch.
Sure.
Here's Matt.
The second place finish at Daytona in the 500 for Bubba Wallace, but today an 8th place finish here at Texas. Is this the type of step that this program needs to build?
Absolutely. Hell yeah, we needed that. That was a good week off for us to regroup. Guys did a hell of a job all weekend long. I thought we had pretty decent speed, and a lot of people in the garage were like, your car's pretty good, so just don't mess it up. And I had a couple opportunities there, especially the first stop coming down, but man, our click and flow Chevrolet was pretty decent all day for us, and Drew did a great job doing some pit strategy on that last call to get us out there to fourth. And I don't know if we were on the splitter that last run, but she just went and turned going down in the corners and gave up a couple spots. But beat myself up over that one, but still walking away with my first top 10 in the Cup Series is pretty good. Really good day for us. You know, we had some prospects up on the box, so I think that went a long way as well. But man, what a good day. What a good day. What a good weekend for us. I had the mojo the whole time. And just super excited. So thanks Coca-Cola, NASCAR, Click and Close, Maui Jim, everybody involved in our program, SDP, Air Force. You know, we do so much for this small team. And these little runs, these big runs are going a long way for us.
Continue to build this program, not only in performance, Chris, but also in the sponsorship department.
Thank you, Matt and Bubba. And so the guy who's been in the last 3 championship final 4 of NASCAR, Kyle Busch, back in the playoffs again with his first victory of 2018, celebrating in Texas. And Vince Welch is down there for the celebration.
After 3 second place finishes, he finally puts it in victory lane, and man, you've had to earn it. What's going through your mind there when you got to hold off Harvick and he's charging and you know it?
Yeah, they were probably just a tick faster overall, but I just had to make sure to do everything I could to hit all my marks and everything, to focus on making sure that I did the right things to block his air a little bit, you know. But this Interstate Batteries Camry was really awesome today, so really want to thank Interstate. It's their hometown. Norm Miller's here, so this one means a lot more to win here in Texas, right here in the hometown of the Interstate Batteries guys. And can't say enough about M&M's, everybody from them, NOS Energy Drink, Cessna, DBX Eyewear, and Black Clover, and of course the fans. You know, this has been a trying couple of months, I guess. You know, after Daytona, we've just been on a roll of finishing really good and been really pumped and excited about that and the momentum we were able to carry. But frustrated at the same time trying to get the victory lane.
You knew it was just a matter of time until you got the win, but how good does it finally feel to be here today?
I mean, it feels awesome. I mean, just anytime you can win at a track that kind of isn't maybe one of your favorites or isn't one of your best, then it definitely means even more, you know, because it just, you try to focus on those tracks and make it a little bit more meaningful and a little bit more special to get it done. So, so cool, though, to be in victory lane here finally this year and, you know, punch our ticket into the playoffs, and of course, you know, also just continue our hot streak of being the points leader right now and keeping these guys focused on what we need to do all year long.
Well done. Kyle Busch wins at Texas for the third time. Jamie?
From the mentor to the protege, Eric Jones finishes 4th today. Your best finish this year, but most importantly, your best finish since joining Joe Gibbs Racing. Do you feel like you guys turned a corner here today?
Well, I think so. We've been kind of inching there each week, getting closer and closer. Martinsville's kind of its own animal, but each week in the mile and a half and 2 miles, we've been getting better. So did the race with Camry up front, and just in the top five was a big moment for us. It's something I've been wanting to do here with this group, and we did a good job of it this weekend. So Texas is a place I like. I got to say thanks to Pit Crew. They worked really hard. We had a rough start for the year on pit road, but they knocked them out. We picked up a lot of spots on pit road today, and that was huge for us. So just a good day overall, and a lot to build on for Bristol.
Thanks, Eric. Well done.
14 straight years now that Kyle Busch has at least won one
race. I never stopped.
Our season is
and
so nervously watching now.
At Long Beach next week.
Husband in Victory Lane. We'll have more from Texas in just a moment.